So you need to show him, yes, I need you. I need you this relationship. I'm interested in you. That's why I followed you.
Amen.
That you show him you need him. Every man, when you try to show him you don't need him, you are killing his nature. You are killing his ability to love and to care. Please note that. If you show man, I don't need you, you are killing his ability to love and care. So now that I show man, I don't need you, you have killed the nature of that man. Because his nature is to take care of you. So you need to prove to him that you need him. And open that life. And that will make this be fulfilled in marriage.
Hallelujah.
It will be fulfilled in that relationship. Women, many of them men, I want to remind you, they are filled with bitterness. Because of their husbands. Not because of anything else. There's some women are not angry with COVID-19. In fact, it is not even affecting many women. They are angry. Their COVID is man.
Their COVID is man. Jesus Christ.
They are angry with man. Bitterness. Because of the ones that were been pouring poisonous things that you have been releasing over years. Those poisonous things you have been saying. And you have released them over years. A woman who is married yesterday does not understand this.
Yeah.
5 years and above. You understand what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Poisonous things that you have released. Instead of you cleansing, you are defiling through the poisonous ones. Now, you need to change. We said that.
Amen.
The day before yesterday.
Yes.
You need to change. And instead, you repent and tell her, I'm sorry.
Amen.
I was perverted.
Yeah.
I was used in the wrong way. I was supposed to put you the right pregnancy. I put you the wrong one. I released the wrong seed instead of the right one. Because the woman, the man is the determiner of every seed.
That's true.
Even the men who are angry because they have only daughters and they ask their wife, why can't you give me a son? Who is supposed to give the other? You are the one. Even in fact, your wife should be angry with you. Because you are the one field to release the seed of a son. That's biological. You will ask and they will tell you, even the teachers in your school. So it's the man who determines.
Yeah.
The woman takes care of what she's given.
See, actually, she will nurture.
She will nurture what she's given and multiply and return it to you. So you give. So listen to me, men. Instead of you using your words in the negative way, use them in the positive way. This woman wants to hear. She is the best, the most important thing in the world. You speak to her and say, you are the angel, the best thing that ever happened in my life. And the more you talk, that the more she smiles. Because she is
actually, you are releasing life. That is
she
life.
She feels nice.
Yes.
You are the angel. You are beautiful. No woman likes to be told she is not beautiful. Because they are created for glory. So everyone wants to hear that. All of them, whether white or black, nothing it is for the certain, whether old or young, they need that. That is what is in their nature. So, husbands, you repent and now begin to shower them with those nice things of love.
Amen.
Shower them with love. Show them how important they are, how valid they are in your life. Show them that they matter in your life. And release that life again and take away poisonous things. Look at what the Bible is telling us in the book of Colossians, chapter 3:19. It says, husband, love your wives and do not be bitter towards them.
Now, can you repeat that?
Husbands, love your wives and do not be bitter towards them. That bitterness is what has made you to release it to your wife. And the wife, you release more bitterness to the wife that is not visible with naked eyes. The wife will give you 3 kilos, 4 kilos, 10 kilos. Those are qualified of bitterness.
Yeah.
So she will return. So men, let me tell you this. I told you I have a revelation. you don't repent, a cleanser with the good ones and shower with the good ones, you will reap.
What? Hallelujah. You will reap.
You will reap that bitterness that she is carrying in her heart. When she will deliver.
The time of deliverance.
The time of deliverance. You will not like it.
So and it's our season. And
don't
it comes.
Don't wait for the time of delivery. Wash that pregnancy. Flush
yeah.
it.
Yeah. Yeah.
There are some abortions that are allowed.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Abortions of evil.
Mm-hmm.
When evil thinks to conceive in your mind, you're your supposed
heart,
to abort it.
Yes.
Because the Bible says, where is this thing coming? Is it out of the evil desire you conceive?
Mm.
You conceive it. And then you produce what?
Yeah.
When the evil desire matures, it produces sin.
Mm. Mm.
So you are supposed to flush out
yes.
evil desire
yes.
before it matures to be a sin. So I advise men today for free that if you don't want this to come back to you again, multiplied, filled together, shaken, overflowing.
Oh my God.
Please flush it out.
Mm.
Take away that bitterness, because these people are bitter. If you want your wife to tell you the truth, go and show repentance and give her time to talk.
Yeah.
She will abort it and you will understand what she was carrying in her heart. When she is forgiving you, she will tell you.
Mm-hmm.
She will tell you, this is what I was feeling.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
This is what I was carrying. Sure, it was about. Some men are so stressed. They cannot fit in their own house as I speak now. Life has become too hard for them because now the pregnancy matured and the bitterness has now been born. Those things you see, which you don't like, you say, this woman is acting like a man woman. Some women, when they are delivering, they act like man.
Yeah, that's what happens.
They act like man. That pain makes them move from the normal realm, physical realm,
that
into another realm.
Labor.
That
yeah,
pain.
Yeah.
So some women are in pain. She can start screaming and beating everything around the house. Because you have managed to put that kind of things, and the time of delivery now is up. And she will talk. Umenifikisha hapa.
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 Unasikia utapika sasa.
So, that means things are bad.
Yes.
She feel like now vomiting you.
And, oh my God.
So, please, I pray. Don't wait for that child to be born. Begin showering them. Change. Let them give birth to something else.
Amen.
Shower them with something good.
Mm.
Shower them with the nice ones. Tell how pretty she is. How wonderful she is. Let her catwalk and you see. And give her marks and tell her, you are doing this, you are doing this,
mm-hmm.
you are doing this. And I want to tell her she will be very happy.
And now what if somebody is saying now, my husband does not talk, my husband is very quiet. So a man should be quiet when it comes to the matters that concerns
he must, his wife. How did he win you?
He was talking.
He was talking. Now he should talk.
Even more.
He may talk, he may not talk much, but he may talk what matters.
What matters?
What you are looking is not much, is what matters.
I love that.
Something that is important.
Yeah.
At least a person talks when there is need. So there is need now. Let them talk.
Men talk.
Let them talk. And when they talk, then will be something. Now, I want you to understand this. Wives are very different. That's why we are saying all the needs they have. It is shameful, men, when you continually distance yourself from your wife. Every time she wants to come close, you distance because she needs attention. You feel that she needs help. She is reaching out for help. You said that she does not need, even when she's talking, she's not in need of you to solve that problem. She talks for the sake of talking.
She
wants somebody to
listen.
Just that.
Mm.
And when she talks, let's feel okay. Now, it is shameful when you start distancing. You keep on resisting her. Distancing yourself from her. Distancing yourself from what she wants to reach you with.
Mm.
And now, when you feel she is disturbing you. That is something that is disturbing your peace. something taking away your peace. You mistake what gives her peace as taking away your peace. Mm-hmm. Then I want to tell you, and you weigh her, something she asks to be close to you, as that she is distracting you.
Mm-hmm.
Because women ask questions more than any body that you can imagine. You think they have been sent to interrogate you. They want to know deep things.
It's because they are helpers. We are helpers. Mm-hmm. So you want the information.
So these women want information.
Yeah, so that we can be effective as we
so help. That she can help you. Mm. So she will ask you some questions. Mm-hmm. She will ask, where are you going?
Where are you taking
not that us? She is not believing you.
Mm-hmm.
So men take that as if it is distrusting him. Where are you going? You have to answer that question and answer it well. Well,
and clearly.
What are you doing? Even she is seeing, but she is asking you. She wants the details of what you are doing.
Clarity.
What are you doing? I mean, see, can't you see? Please don't tell the woman, can't you see? Tell her what you are doing.
And what you are thinking.
Why did you take so long? You went out. She won't understand. So why are you asking I took him so long?
Don't you trust
me? Mm-mm. That is not about trust. She wants details.
Yeah.
Did you experience challenge? Did you have any problem? She is not being noisy by doing that.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
That's her nature. She is not being noisy and she is not disturbing. That is who she is. Why is she asking you those questions? This is how she is. And if you will cut that off, you will live with a woman who is not real.
Yeah.
Because she will pretend. She will not ask you, but she has that need. So she will not be the real person you want to stay with.
Mm-hmm.
And some things you will see now, they are not happening. You say, why? Why are you so cold? Why are you so... So you cut what makes her hot.
Yeah.
How will she not be cold? If the fire, you have quenched it. Why will she not be cold? So, what is so secretive, man, that you cannot tell your helper?
Mm.
What is so secretive that you cannot disclose it to your helper so that your helper can help you
unveil
it? What is so secretive? That means there is nothing that you are not able to tell your wife.
Hallelujah.
If those questions are not answered well, she's blocked. She does not know how to help you. And she came to that marriage as an helper. If she cannot help you, she will look for somebody else to help.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Let me tell you, men, for free. Most women are very committed in the church. And they are helping pastors to realize their dreams.
Mm-hmm.
While their husbands are suffering because the husbands do not give them room.
Yeah. Environment.
So when they go to the church, they are taught, they are given responsibility, they are trusted. Yeah. What will happen?
They will be very effective.
They will be very effective.
Yeah. They will run with a vision.
They will run with a vision.
Mm.
That's why you see, time of Jesus, women were in front.
Actually, they are there.
They were there helping. So you go everywhere, in every church, you will see it is women who are very busy running with a vision.
Very effective.
So the way they are helping in the kingdom, they is the same way. They are supposed to help in your marriage.
Okay.
It's the same way they're supposed to help in the family.
Mm.
So once you understand this, this woman needs this intimacy.
Mm.
This woman needs attention, yeah. Affection.
Yeah.
And you don't change it. Don't nag her for that. Don't criticize her for her. That is her nature. And the woman also understands man needs honor, respect. A man needs sex.
Yeah.
Don't criticize him for that.
Mm-hmm.
Don't criticize and say, you, this is too much. It is not too much. It may be too much with you, but not too much with the one who needs.
Yeah.
So supply what is needed and you shall be happy.
Wow.
Welcome, my dear.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
It is powerful. It is awesome, and we thank God. So I believe every man you have understood.
Amen.
And we say that you should be very comfortable with what makes your spouse comfortable. Mm-hmm. You may not be comfortable. You may not. Of course, it's not even your need, but mm-hmm. you are supposed to supply it
mm-hmm.
so that this person will function well.
Mm-hmm.
And choking your spouse with what he or she desires, then it is working against that marriage.
Mm-hmm.
You have become an enemy of your own marriage.
Mm-hmm.
So make sure that you are doing what is right, and you're going to enjoy the benefits. You're
Amen.
Going to enjoy. And I believe that I said God cannot do your part.
Uh-huh.
So as men do your part, mm-hmm. as our wife do your part.
Amen.
And the rest is joy. The rest is happiness. The rest is excitement. And let me tell you, there are things that people are not doing, as long as they are not being supplied with such things,
mm-hmm.
especially what men need or what they require, what women need. You're seeing some people, they are being oppressed.
Mm-hmm.
And people are even growing old very early
mm-hmm.
because they are so much oppressed.
Mm-hmm.
What is supposed to give them life
mm-hmm.
to thrive?
Mm-hmm.
Because people who, it is even scientifically proven,
mm-hmm.
people who laugh often, they
mm-hmm.
prolong their days.
Mm-hmm.
People who are happy,
they're laughing.
Mm-hmm.
The joy,
they prolong their life. And that's why the Bible endorses it, that the joy of the Lord is our strength.
Mm-hmm.
Meet a woman who is happy.
Mm-hmm.
This woman, even at our 70s, you mistake her with a 40-year-old
mm-hmm.
lady. Why? Mm-hmm. The environment that she's in, she's driving well, very well,
mm-hmm.
she's glowing, she's flourishing, and this is what makes her to be that woman. Something else that is also very important that women require, they require trust and
mm-hmm.
honesty.
Mm-hmm.
And
that's a need.
It's a need.
Number three, need yeah, of a woman.
They require honest. They
and
want
trust.
A man who is honest. They want a man who is trustworthy.
Mm-hmm.
Who can be trusted,
mm-hmm.
a man who can be trusted with vision, a man who can be trusted with every secret. There are men who have refused. They have been trapped on the other side of their lives.
Mm-hmm.
They married and they forgot that they are married.
Mm-hmm.
We call them mommy's boys.
Mm-hmm.
And you can imagine if a woman is married by a mommy's boy.
Mm-hmm. A boy who has refused to grow.
A boy who has refused to grow.
Mm.
It's only that this boy is speaking. He has base, he has beards, and he has maybe children, and he has a wife.
Mm.
But everything that he is doing,
mm-hmm.
he is doing from another territory.
Mm-hmm.
He has never relocated from the territory
mm-hmm.
of his parents.
Mm-hmm.
So he is always there. He is always connected.
Mm-hmm.
He cannot do anything in his family,
mm-hmm.
in his kingdom.
Mm-hmm.
He does not operate his kingdom as a king.
Mm-hmm.
He has refused to be inaugurated into kingship.
Mm-hmm.
He has remained as a prince. You see, when you are a prince, you are just allowed to, there are some levels that you operate in the kingdom.
Mm-hmm.
You, when you walk out there, you are honored as a prince, but that kingship,
mm-hmm.
it's not there. So such men, even their own wives, they fear to trust them
mm-hmm.
with some things because this man
cannot be trusted.
He cannot be trusted.
Mm-hmm.
When we prepare, when we speak something, when we plan something,
mm-hmm.
we will agree, and you tell me, yes, this is a good idea.
Mm-hmm.
I have searched the information from
mm-hmm.
you
mm-hmm.
because you are the source, of course.
Mm-hmm.
So I have gotten the what I'm supposed to get from you,
mm-hmm.
and thinking that we are now running this race, we are working with this project, we are doing this thing, only to hear maybe tomorrow you have
mm-hmm.
called your mother,
mm.
Then you tells me, I talked with mom, and mom told me this is not the right time.
Mm-hmm. There's something that I'm getting as you are speaking.
Yeah.
And it's good to speak revelation when they come.
Yeah.
Honest and trust
mm-hmm.
are catalyst for something.
Yeah.
So every man who has proven to be honesty
and
can be trusted by the wife,
yeah.
helps the wife
to be more submissive,
to
humble more.
So it is very difficult for a woman
mm-hmm.
to submit to a man who is not trustworthy,
yeah,
and a man honest. Who is not honest,
yeah,
in his dealings.
There are some ladies who are speaking provocative words to their husbands because this man cannot be trusted. This man is not honest. He is not sincere. You see, honesty, it's that ability that you can be sincere. So we talk here, then you just turn things around. That is betrayal. And that's why many ladies have gone to that level of asking their husband, what kind of a man
are you? Who do you take me for?
Yeah.
And who am I
to you?
So in time the lady sees you can't be trusted,
yes,
or you are not trusting her,
yeah,
because she will interpret the reason why you are keeping away information from her,
yes, it's because
the reason why you cannot answer those questions the way she wants,
yeah,
the reason why you keep resisting her when she wants to understand something is because you cannot trust her.
You cannot trust her.
So, in other words, she is looking at things like this.
Yeah.
Transparency
is the key.
It's the key thing here. I want a husband who is transparent.
Yeah.
Very easy to read.
You see, when we are talking about understand. Transparency, it is that nakedness. You are just you are barely open. There's nothing that you're covering. There's nothing that you're hiding. There's nothing that is too big for your wife to know. So if you can just be a person who does not want some things to be
known,
you are locking them in
down for yourself.
Yeah,
it may not be even a bad intention.
Yeah.
But you are locking them away from the one who needs
who
to know.
Needs that information more.
Mm-hmm.
So this person will feel displaced.
Mm-hmm.
This person will feel betrayed.
Mm-hmm.
This person's confidence, your wife's confidence, will be crushed.
Mm-hmm.
So failure to be trusted and to be honest crushes the confidence of your wife.
So submission is difficult.
It is difficult.
She and you want her to submit.
It will not be possible.
Mm-hmm.
It can't be. Because when you supply this, you get this. You supply this, it's like you supply a certain tender, you get money in return. You get what you agreed in
you
return.
You sow a seed,
you get harvest in return. So a man who cannot be trusted by the wife, a man who is not honest towards whatever he is doing to this woman, this woman will feel betrayed. She will feel that in one way or the other, she made a mistake. There are people who are living in a marriage and they feel that they made a mistake. A mistake to be married by this man. A mistake to come and submit herself, to give herself away
to this person.
And now she will stay in this marriage, not of love. She will stay in marriage because
she is committed emotionally to this man. She has invested all her feeling to this person.
Yes.
So she feels total rejection and total betrayal.
Yeah.
Because this man is no longer
trusted
and this man is no longer honest with his dealings.
So she'll be in marriage because she does not want to break the word of God that God hates in divorce. Others will be in marriage not because there is any connection between them and their husband. It is because of the development that they have made and the children. The development, she don't want to go and start level zero. Others, they have stayed there for 30 years. Investing your years, 30 years in your marriage, living and just going out there, but it cannot be something very easy. So there are ladies who are in marriage, they are living with a man who cannot be trusted.
So in other words, you are saying this,
this
woman is in the marriage because of other things.
Yeah.
That means there's something she has cut off. She has cut off that desire to be supplied with this need. And when she has cut up this desire to be supplied with this need, that means she will die one side. She want to help you, she want to be out there to help you. She will die
on
their side. Then you will become a stranger, and this woman will begin out to say, I don't know my husband
anymore.
I don't understand my husband anymore. So you may blame this woman and say, why can't you understand your husband that you are one married to? And this, what made her to understand this man is cut off. Is that this man is not opening the book.
Yeah.
So how can I discover something that is sealed? Now, men, listen to me. I advise you for free. Sometimes we think the most important tool that God has given you in marriage is something that is between your legs. But you are wrong.
It's not. It's not.
Because this is what really makes men mistake things, act the way they are not supposed to act. They think that when you are now with a woman, she has come, she has done sex with you. That's all.
No.
Even when you are so, you have done mistakes, you think when you sleep with her, that's a way of
actually
saying sorry.
You offend her more.
But that's the way to men. That's a way of saying sorry.
No. No.
to a woman, that is something wrong.
Actually, it's
you are supposed to apologize. Yes. You are supposed to do something
but
else.
But how many men today sweet they are apologizing?
They don't do it.
They don't.
So they say sorry. Right, they say some things. Then all of a sudden, because you have come waiting for that apology, waiting for that once to come, then this man goes ahead and sleeps with you.
If a woman will be content and happy.
Mm.
When you have done something wrong, even if you go and buy a car, you just come, honey, this is your gift, and you have not
apologized,
visited what you did,
that
thing will still
will not hurt her. It will not make her happy because she was hurt.
First of all, apologize. Then tell me this is the gift. That gift will be well appreciated.
Now listen to me. Even when you apologize alone also, without taking action.
Yes.
It does not enforce it.
Yeah.
So when I apologize and I bring a card, I bring a flower, I bring a gift, then an apology sinks.
Yes, it is.
Because
it is
shows this commitment.
You are serious.
I'm not thanking with the mouth.
Yeah.
I have come with a thanksgiving offering.
I like that.
Now, listen to me, man. Listen to me this. The most important tool in your marriage is your mouth. If you get that
and
right,
it has been
that's where the seed, that's where the cleansing comes. The one comes from the mouth.
You scatter from your mouth.
So the most important tool, man, in your marriage is your ones. Your mouth now.
Hallelujah.
Is the most important tool. This woman, before you saw what is in the middle of your legs, she followed your ones. There are things you spoke.
And convince
and her. And convince this woman. Mm. So she followed once. There are things that you said. So let us understand as men now, the most important tool in our marriage is our mouth.
Amen.
If we can use this mouth very well, you speak. You speak to this woman. She needs to hear you speak. You apologize. When she asks those questions, answer them and answer them out of love. Answer those questions honestly. Don't lie, because a woman will be difficult to love a person who is lying to her. And some women will pretend they don't want to get you red-handed and to prove to you are lying. They may stop at some point. Not just to discredit you and dethrone you, because they have that respect as a husband. But in her heart, she will be affected. She knows this man, I can no longer trust him. So the women who know that the man is trusted and is honest with every dealing, she is more comfortable to submit.
Amen.
It is difficult to submit to a man or love a man that you don't trust.
Yes.
The same way to the woman.
Mm.
So let us take this with a lot of weight.
Yeah.
That when this woman wants you to explain the plans,
please explain.
Explain it.
And when we plan,
not all times we surprise.
Yeah.
Not all time you surprise.
Yeah.
Some things men can lie and say, I want them to surprise. No. But you know in your heart you never want them to surprise. And women have another sense.